You know, actress Sarah Jessica Parker has been seen as unattractive among the world. So many people find her so unattractive. Maxim magazine back in 2008 had a list of the unsexiest women. She was named like number one unsexiest woman alive. Obviously, Sarah Jessica Parker was upset and hurt. She said, "Am I really the ugliest woman in the world? Wow, it's kind of shocking. First of all, why would Maxim bother listing the unsexiest women? Just wasting time having a list of people being considered unattractive based off looks? Second of all, Maxim, you're wrong for this, and screw you." Now, Sarah Jessica Parker is married to actor Matthew Broderick since May 19th, 1997. I'm sure you guys are aware of Matthew Broderick. He was in the Ferris Bueller movie. He played Inspector Gadget in the live-action Inspector Gadget movie back in 1999. They have been married for almost 22 years. Plus, they have children. She mentioned about her being the ugliest woman alive to her husband about the list. And it left him quite upset. Like, hey, that's my wife they're talking about. What does she do to deserve this? I'm sure Matthew Broderick finds his wife attractive, and he should. If someone you're in a relationship feels like him or her is unattractive, then a significant other should find a way to make that special someone feel better about him or herself, letting him or her also know they are attractive in their own way. Some say she looks like a horse, or she resembles a witch like the witch of Wizard of Oz due to the pimple on her chin. Last time I checked, I thought horses were considered beautiful animals. Unless people mean ugly as, like, this horse have their mouths open and the way their teeth looks. If horses are considered pretty, then really that means Sarah Jessica Parker is pretty. As for the pimple on her chin, sure, she could use Proactive. I'm sure she's aware of the pimple on her chin. But maybe she doesn't care about the pimple, you know? Maybe she's tried everything, but there's nothing else she can do about it. I mean, people act like the pimple continues to grow and grow until it explodes. And once it gets puffy and red and all the white pus comes out. I think Sarah Jessica Parker is pretty. Not supermodel pretty. She may not be in the top 10 of gorgeous women in the world, let alone Hollywood. But I don't consider her unattractive unless we go by personality. I haven't read or heard about her being a mean, rude biatch. So if that's not the case, why judge her based off her appearance? Some will say they find her more attractive in the 80s and 90s. In 2019, absolutely not. I like the outfit and hat she wore in the recent Stella Artois commercial. I think she has a beautiful, lovely smile, pretty eyes. Is she still unattractive besides the lovely smile she has?
The only time you will ever see the light is when you feel the vibe and your mind is open wide. I said the only time you will ever see the light is when you feel the vibe and your mind is open.
Not to mention, some people think she's ugly because she has a big nose. Well, some people are going to have big nose. Some people have small noses. But that doesn't make them unattractive because they have a big nose or a big honker, as they like to say. This reminds me of Mayim Bialik, who plays Amy on The Big Bang Theory. And also, I'm sure you guys remember her from the 90s show Blossom, originally on NBC back in the day. In this article, which you can check in the link in the description box, she says that she considered getting plastic surgery many times, especially due to this photo of this SNL sketch. It's a SNL Blossom sketch. Apparently, TV critics insulted her nose when she was on Blossom, especially when it came to this SNL spoofed Blossom. They use a large, hideous, prosthetic nose on this actress right here who played her. And it hurt her dearly that she thought about getting plastic surgery. See, this is what I'm talking about. Mayim Bialik, I don't think she's ugly. I think she's pretty cute in her own way. Who cares if she has a big nose? She has a cute big nose. It suits her. That's all I have to say. Do you guys personally think Sarah Jessica Parker is unattractive or not? And also, February 14th, tomorrow, Valentine's Day. Who cares? If you want to treat yourself on Valentine's Day, go ahead and go out and get you some ice cream and plenty of chocolate candy. Lots and lots of chocolate. And don't be worrying about trying to get in a relationship for just one day or whatever. It's that Hallmark crap. All right, see ya.